Hello everyone, welcome to the fourth tutorial. The topic is multiple linear regression. In all previous tutorials, we've been talking about linear regression model with a scalar input x and a scalar output y, with only one parameter, the linear weight, theta. But as we introduced at the very beginning, a more general linear model for scalar input and output would be this, where theta1 is the linear weight and theta0 is the intercept. In this tutorial, we will further extend the scalar input to multiple inputs with the scalar output, written as this. Y is still the neural response, x1, x2, all the way to xd, are multiple stimulus features, such as orientation, contrast, and etc. There are d features in this model, and theta1 all the way to theta d are the linear weights in front of these features, and theta0 is still the intercept. Each theta d gives you the impact of xd onto the neural response. More generally, we can write it in vector form for each data point I. Both the bode theta and bode xi are vectors. The elements in theta are the linear weights for each feature and intercept. And each element in the vector xi corresponds to each input feature for this data point. I is from 1 to n. We could also build it up to the matrix version. Y is capital X multiplying theta. Bold Y here becomes a column vector collecting all responses. Capital X is a matrix. Each column corresponds to a feature and each row corresponds to a data point. We call it design matrix. Theta is still the same vector. After formally defining the multiple linear model, we should discuss the mean squared error for it. A quick recap from the previous slide is that we defined MSE for scalar input and show that the residual is the vertical distance between 1 and y hat. But now, since we go to higher dimensions with multiple inputs, we cannot easily plot a linear function as shown here. But we can provide some geometric interpretation of multiple linear model with a 2D example. Again, for simplicity, the 2D case doesn't have the intercept. We first plot x1, x2 on this regression plane. The model predict is y hat, which is a linear combination of theta1, x1, and theta2, x2 on the same regression plane. Now we could plot the y we want to regress to, which is off the plane. And the residual e is the vector pointing from y to y hat. Thus, minimizing MSE for this 2D linear model would be equivalent to minimizing square of the residual between y and y hat. Next, we give the formal mathematical expression of MSE for the multiple linear regression model using the matrix version expression. It is the 2 norm of the vector x multiplying theta minus y, which is expanded as the sum of squared distance between yi and theta multiplying xi for all data points I. Still, n is the number of data points. We differentiate it and set the gradient to be 0, and we arrive at this closed form solution for theta, which is x transpose x inverse multiplying x transpose y. Similarly, we could write down the log likelihood with the matrix version too. Now we add back the Gaussian noise eta, and I'm going to do the derivation step by step again to make sure you're all familiar with the derivation of MLE. We first write down the log likelihood as the log of the probability density function for all data, which is then expanded as the log of the product of all data points. We move the product to the outside of the logarithm and arrive at the summation form. Now we bring the density function expression here to replace py given x and theta. Here, d is the number of input features, or the number of elements in the vector theta or x. Then we separate the log term into two terms. The first term doesn't involve data index I, thus is constant across data points and can be written as n multiplying d over 2 multiplying log 2 pi sigma squared. And in the second term, logarithm is cancelled by exponential, therefore leaving us this quadratic form. We could finally rewrite the summation of quadratics into vector multiplication. Next, we differentiate it and set the gradient to be zero. We arrive at the closed form solution for theta, which is again the same as the MSE estimator. Therefore, we know that no matter its scalar input or multiple inputs, the MSE and MLE estimates are always the same if the noise eta is Gaussian. One more thing I want to introduce under this multilinear regression topic is polynomial regression. The expression is defined here. Previously, each input variable is a different stimulus feature like contrast or orientation, but here the input is the same feature x, but with different powers. We introduce this model here because we want to better characterize the link between stimulus and neural response, which appears to be not completely linear in many cases. More generally, we can write the vector form for one data point as this. The vector theta is the same, but the vector of x is 1x, x squared, x to the third power, and etc. Compared to the linear model, x has different values, x has different elements, x1, x2, and x3. And the matrix version is the same as the linear model. So although we define a new polynomial regression model with nonlinear powers, but the coupling between the weight theta and the inputs are still linear. The only difference is the input vector is now a collection of the same scalar feature x raised up to different powers, and thus we can also use the same MSE and MLE estimators to estimate optimal theta for polynomial regression. In a notebook, you will build design matrix for multiple linear regression. You will calculate MSE and MLE solutions with matrix forms. An exercise would be generate simulated data from a polynomial model. You build design matrix for the polynomial model with increasing powers, and you calculate MSE and MLE solutions with matrix form for this polynomial regression model. Hope you enjoy that.